So welcome back. Last session we talked about water pressure, water flow, a faucet with a tap to control that. Then we came to the equivalency in electronics where we have a faucet controlled by a base entity where the charge flows through the collector to the emitter. We make a reference to ground and we use the battery in this case, positive and negative side of it, to create the charge. The actual flow is current in amperes, small a, oh sorry, we can put an a there for example, as the symbol for units of measurements, V for volts, and a resistance in ohms. Okay, so that's fine, but let's do something a little more practical. What we're going to do is let's put a circuit together. So I'm going to use that as the feed in for the source of charge. And I'm going to come down, and in this case here, let me just do something. Okay, that's my transistor. What I'm doing is just as you, when you go to use the faucet, use the taps in your house, you set it up to some position that you're happy with the flow. We have a similar analogy in this electronics here, where we set this transistor, not the faucet, but the same idea. You set the transistor up so it's controlling a flow that we're happy with. It goes to a steady state situation. We call this biasing our transistor, okay? We're going to bias this transistor. Now, as you know with electronics, that the current flows in one direction. These devices normally only handle current flow in one direction. And that's how we design them for and optimize them for. And thus, we will have, this is our source, we'll make this one plus, this is our ground, this is our return, these two come back together just like we have in the battery over here. One more time, this is our collector, this is our emitter, and this is our base for this particular NPN transistor. Okay, so this point here, we normally call it the collector, say, charge source, okay? So we label it VCC, okay? This, we're going to put pressure, voltage, pressure, on the base. So I'm going to call this point here VB. The thing about our faucet, or our transistor in this case here, is we like to know what's going on all around it. So we will also try and determine what is VC. What is the value of VE? And in order to control the flow, we're using resistors. In this case here, this resistor will be a collector resistor. And this will be an emitter resistance. And this, because we're using two, let's just call this R1 and R2 for now. Now, one thing you'll notice is because I said it flows in one direction, at least from the perspective of setting this up, this in one direction is known as direct current, abbreviated by, our business is full of abbreviations, acronyms, DC. So direct current is direct current flow, means goes in one direction. I use the analogy of eating. You know, you eat from the mouth and it comes out. We don't do it the other way around, so get your polarities right when you do these things. Okay, now let's set this bias up for this device. We need to determine, what I would like you to do is figure out what is this value here first. What is VB? Looking at the circuit, what do we know? You know a couple of things. You know what the value of these resistors are. You just know because you had to design the circuit. You then also realize that you had, remember, that 0.7 volt, in this case here, let's use 0.7 volt voltage drop across a silicon NPN transistor from base to emitter. What does that leave us? Okay, we also need to know what is the flow. So we're going to try and determine not only this voltage, and this voltage. Let me just jot them down here. We also want to know what is this flow of current, okay, the collector current, what is this flow of current, the emitter current, and what is this flow of current, which is going to be the base current. All right, so let's see what's going on over here. We need to calculate that. Now back to Ohm's law, we have a voltage and a resistance. So figuring out this particular current flow, let's do that. We know that I, from Ohm's law, just juxtaposing the equation, is equal to V, in this case here, CC, over the total resistance in that circuit. Okay? In that case there, you will know what the voltage, you will know what the flow of current is down through this circuit. Now, if that is the case, knowing what this current, we said we're looking for this particular current is, knowing what that current is, then realizing that we're pushing back with this resistance here, we should be able to determine what is the pressure at the top of this resistor as a result of that current flow. So that would be basically R2 times this current flow will give us a voltage there. We can also look at this equation and we can go through the interpretation and realize that another way of doing this is saying, oh, the value of the voltage here, and let me just jot it down, is R2 over R1 plus R2 times VCC, and that will be equal to our base voltage. We know these values, we know this value, this is our battery, which means that we can calculate VB. We've got VB, we've got a 0.7 volt drop. We've got a pressure here at the emitter. Now, if we have the voltage here, if we have VE known, and we have RE as a resistance, guess what? Ohm's law again. So in this case here, IE equal to, in this case, VE over RE, that's solved. So we've got this, this, this. What's left? Well, we'll also need to calculate the collector current and the base current. Okay, let's see how we're going here. At this point in time, I would like you to make an assumption. What we actually see here is that, yes, there is a bit of current going into the base, usually quite small, this one here. And there is a current coming down here through the collector. Both of them actually combine to give you IE. But the reality is this base current is very, very small. So if we ignore that or we make an approximation, what we can say is IC is approximately equal to IE. It's going to help us immensely in our calculations. That being the case, then we know IE, then we know IC. If I know IC and I know RC, and I realize that you need a pressure across this resistor in order to make it push current through, then essentially I can say what is the voltage at the collector. That will be equal to VCC minus this voltage drop, which is IC times RC, all right? So we've got our voltage, pressure there, flow here. Now what is IB? Ah, good question. Let's do it this way. These devices have gain. Little bit of in control gives me lots of out. Another symbol for gain is beta. Beta is actually a ratio of what you're coming through divided by what you've got going in. Notice we're talking about current. This is a current-driven device. So if I know what IC is, and I will tell you, the manufacturer will tell you what the gain of the transistor is, let's just use a number like 100, in this case for this particular device. Then I would just take IC, which we've calculated, okay, and I would divide it by 100, and I would have IB using juxtaposition of this formula, okay? IC over beta equals IB. So that's the essence in setting up a bias point, a steady state point, a point we're happy with where the flow is from a DC direct current perspective. And you are therefore required to understand what's going on around this device and through this device. IC, IE, IB, VB, VC, and VE. Coming back, we'll take this concept a little further in the next video.